Damn, these things are so hard to chew. Good afternoon, it's Saturday, everyone. What was that? What? It feels so good. I don't know, just waking up today felt so good. I stayed up very late yesterday watching MDL Macau. VP was playing the last series of the day. They are in lower bracket, so they were playing against newbie. And it's kind of interesting to watch that matchup and have a zero care for newbie because things have just changed so much. They used to be my favorite team, but now I kind of don't care about them. They changed rosters and stuff like that. So luckily, I woke up this morning to see that VP won. I was only able to stay up until 4, I just couldn't do it anymore. They won the first game, so I was like, oh yeah, they're gonna 2-0 them, I'm gonna go to bed, I can't do this anymore. Let me... What is this pupper's doing? You hear all that noise in the background? So look... Well, actually, let's go around here. Open the blinds, it's so beautiful today, it's sunny. So, look at all that sun! It's so nice. It has been raining a lot in San Diego for the past few weeks, honestly. So these sunny days haven't really been happening consistently, which is why when I saw that it would be sunny on the forecast these next few days, I was so excited and so happy about it. Right now there is frostbite going on. That was very convenient. So right now it's just pools, which is why I'm probably going to at least take her for a walk now, because when it's so nice out, you just need to at least spend some time outside, and I think that's really good. I don't know why my camera was having trouble focusing on my spin bike earlier, but anyways, I purchased one because I really would like to start doing regular cardio again, and with my knee having issues, I can't run, I can't do jump roping, I can't do a lot of the classic cardio stuff. Just hear this girl with her mouth and her toes tapping the ground. So yeah, wanted to get some cardio in, and it seems like one of those really great ideas where you can watch something really enjoyable while exercising at the same time. So I set it back here behind my couch, that way I have direct vision of my TV, and just hoping to start doing it on a semi-regular basis So at least for spin bikes, I don't think you want to do it every single day. I guess it depends on your intensity, but for me right now, I'm going to be doing very low resistance because I noticed that when I'm on this, if the resistance is too high, my knees feel awful, so I can't really let that happen. The whole point is to not worsen my condition. I think I'm happy with this purchase. There are certain aspects that feel a little flimsy for the price tag. I got this for $270. There was $30 off, so it's normally $300, roughly in that range. And the main reason I am making a big purchase like that is because I get my bonus next month. And I would say that tax returns and my bonus covers a lot of my existing credit card debt. I have roughly $10,000 in credit card debt. So since most of that is paying it off, I am not putting myself into further debt by buying this. And plus, this feels like an expensive purchase that I can feel much less worse about compared to in the past when I bought shoes. This is a better purchase than fashion because this is for your health and it's for fitness. You're so cute. Look at this guy. It's so funny to see cats just lying randomly somewhere, right? Without showing their legs. I love the fact that they hide their limbs. It looks so funny. But it is, yes, time to walk this girl. And then perhaps when I come back in, I will do a spin bike session while watching some Smash. Oh yeah, I have also been playing a lot of Dota Auto Chess. It is a custom game. And it's a lot of fun. I am trying to play more and get better at it, as usual. But I am kind of glad that I tried it out because this is a custom game that has been very popular. A lot of people are playing it, and people from other platforms, like other games on Twitch from Hearthstone, or I don't know other games, but popular streamers are playing this game when they normally don't play Dota. Yeah, it's just very popular, so that was one of the main reasons I was avoiding it at first, but I do admit, it's a lot of fun. I am going to get some Chinese food. So today on Instagram, my brother posted some, I don't know if it was specifically Taiwanese food, but he went to a restaurant in New York, and I have been thinking that since I moved out here, I haven't really had a lot of Chinese food. It definitely makes me sad because that is my favorite type of food. I always ate it, obviously, from my mom making food, and it's just so freaking delicious. But I think my problem over here is that most of the Asian stuff in San Diego is actually right by my work. But the problem with that is it's a very congested and small area, so I don't like to deal with parking when I go there. There is very little parking actually, so if you do ever choose to go there, it is very hard to find a spot, or you end up walking a mile or something crazy like that. So that has discouraged me from ever trying out additional restaurants out there. I just picked up my food and I am heading back now to House Chow Mein. Oh man, oh, it smells so freaking good. So I am driving through my old neighborhood area, not my exact neighborhood, but basically
basically a lot of the surrounding places, the downtownish area that I had within walking distance. And for some reason, every time I walk through a downtown area, it's overwhelming for me when I see a person every 10 feet or something. And I've been in situations like this before, but I tend to always have that reaction internally.
Freaking cat. Oh, food. Yes, so good. Wow, seriously. I dropped my food outside earlier, so it keeps rolling down. I must tie it together so it's not saggy. Put this in the fridge. There we go. Freaking amazing. Maybe I'll get seconds. I kind of don't know the proper way to lead up to something. So I am actually going to a wedding in July. And this is for someone that I knew from my ex-boyfriend during college. So my boyfriend during college, he was a very social guy. He had a lot of friends. And I guess during that period of time, I was pretty decent at being extroverted with him in a sense. So this was a friend of his that I got to know pretty decently. But after college, he was someone I just kept in touch with, and he was reasonably local. So once in a while we would go out to eat dinner together and we would just talk and keep in touch. And he was always the only person I felt like in that state that I knew who I could make plans with, where I knew it would happen, it would be as easy as a time and a place. So I just have a lot of fond memories of this guy because he's just a very reliable, and I felt like that made him a good friend. And even though I would have to fly home, luckily the wedding is going to be in Brooklyn, so I can go home for this. I decided I wanted to because he was just one of the few people in my life who was reliable, so I want to be there for his day. And along the way, I can finally go home for once. I haven't been home yet in nearly 2 years. And I am kind of looking forward to this because I've only been to one wedding as an adult. I feel like once in a while when I get the opportunity to go to an event where you get to dress up, it just kind of excites me a little bit. So I will be going home around the July 4th weekend. Luckily, my company gives me 2 days off. They give me Thursday and Friday off. July 4th is on a Thursday, so I might not even need to spend any of my PTO days for this trip, which would be great because right now I feel like with all my plans for road tripping, if I wanted to go to Montana, I'm hoping to use 5 PTO days for that and stay for a week. But I always reserve 5 days for TI, so TI is already 5. I only get 15 days at my company. 5 days for TI, I'm using 3 for New Mexico. If I use 5 for Montana, then I'm only left with 2 days. So I'm just trying to organize it well, make sure that I use all of my days very wisely. And I guess technically I have one extra day because we have something called Volunteer Day that kind of counts as PTO. You use it in the same sense, although generally you want to use it for volunteering, right? That's the purpose of the day, but they don't ask for proof or anything, so I'm pretty sure most people use it in the form of PTO. Rest of my day is looking like watching some Smash, playing some auto chess. Virtus Pro plays tonight at 9 o'clock, and then finals are at midnight. So if Virtus Pro and the finals again, that would be amazing. That would be so incredible.